On your knees. On the move. In silence or out loud. Alone or in a crowd. It's one of the most common yet mysterious human activities. Today I explore one of our most basic and sublime instincts. Prayer. We have prayerful hymns from the Exultate Singers, Tessera and Camilla Kerslake. We hear from Archbishop Desmond Tutu. I also talk with the Archbishop of Canterbury about prayer and hear of its importance when he was near the Twin Towers on September the 11th, 2001. There have been times during my life where I've definitely prayed for other people, but I've always felt that my real relationship with God was through music. Dr Rowan Williams, the Archbishop of Canterbury, thinks that finding time for prayer should be at the heart of all our lives.
We pray so that we can draw on the deepest sources that there are for life, for hope. We pray to keep ourselves alive, to keep ourselves human, I think. There's a need to believe that when we run out of our resources, there's something in the universe, more than just the sum total of us and our concerns, something like a sort of steady swell under the sea that's with us, and people want to connect with that. They don't know how it works. They're not even quite sure it's there. But there's a need to think that when we come to the end of things, it's not the end of what's there.
Our first hymn is a prayer. It asks that we be given the strength and courage to tread life's steep and rugged pathway rejoicingly with the Lord at our side. It's sung in the beautiful setting of St Swithins Church here in Bath by the Exultate Singers. Archbishop, let me ask you, what is prayer?
Basically, I think prayer is connecting with God. It's putting yourself where God can get at you, it's giving time to God, and it's trying to align yourself with God, with God's own mind, if you want to put it that way.
I always feel that, you know, God is with me throughout the day in everything I do. So why do I need to pray?
When you're on holiday with the family, they're with you all day. You're aware of it. But it would be a very bad family holiday if you didn't sometimes just sit down across the table with children or spouse and say, here we are, let's enjoy the moment, not just running around. I think that's part of where prayer fits in. It's the sitting across the table and saying, well, here we are, let's enjoy this moment together.
Is there a specific way we should pray? Are we supposed to be down on our hands and knees with our hands together?
I think actually the physical position does matter in prayer.
Because, it does matter.
Well, we express ourselves in our bodies, don't we? I talk to you and I wave my hands around a bit. My face changes, my body shifts. So when I pray, I think it's worth asking, what do I want to express? Sometimes what I want to express is adoration, kind of letting go. You kneel, you bow to the ground, whatever. You lie flat on your face, as some people do. Sometimes what you want to express is just listening, just attentiveness. You sit, you calm yourself, you center yourself, and you almost feel your ears growing, you know? And you breathe in and let God be there.